Today I want to read for you one of the clearest passages that just explicitly spells out a post-tribulation rapture, or a rapture that comes after the tribulation. Matthew 24, beginning in verse 29. Immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heavens shall be shaken. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory, and he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Now, we see in this passage certain elements that make it very clear that this is about the rapture, because of course those who are believing in a pre-trib rapture don't want to admit that this is about the rapture. So they try to say, oh, this is a different event altogether. Well, look at the elements that are in this passage. We've got Jesus Christ coming in the clouds, we've got a trumpet sounding, and we've got Jesus Christ gathering together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. It says in Mark 13, just a slightly different wording, when it says, from the uttermost part of earth to the uttermost part of heaven. And so this is clearly the rapture. The Bible says that Jesus comes in the clouds, he gathers the elect, the trumpet sounds. This is exactly what we saw in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4.